I can't believe this has happened to me, but I finally started that descent into the wood turning rabbit hole by making this small mallet on today's episode.
Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Sponsored by toolstoday.com. With a huge selection of saw blades, shaper cutters, router drill, and CNC insert bits, Tools Today is your source for industrial cutting tools. And also by Lee Valley and Veritas. With over 5,000 high-quality woodworking hand tools, visit their online catalog at leevalley.com.
So originally my goal was pretty simple. I just wanted to take this squarish piece of wood and make it rather round instead. So I centered it between my points and I grabbed the rough and gouge and went to town on it. Now immediately I ran into my first lesson, which of course is to double check the tool rest to make sure it's properly locked in position firmly. So thankfully I didn't hurt myself. Now once it's locked, it was then back to work. Now since this piece is longer than my tool rest, I'll work as much of the block at one end and then I'm going to reposition it to finish the rest. My second lesson of course comes up rather quickly again as I learn to be more careful when approaching the untouched end. Thankfully, a nice tight grip and full support of the tool rest keeps the roughing gouge in place. Now, I'm starting to make progress, but it's more important to stop and just see how much progress. At this point, I see I still have a little ways to go as I find this nice flat area. With the first end rounded, it's then time to slide the tool rest down and start making the other end kind of roundish. Now, ordinarily, I'd probably make an effort to match up the two ends as much as possible to make the piece the same dimension, but instead, I'm just going to dive in and begin defining the shape of the mallet head and handle, because at this point I've decided I think I'm going to make kind of a smallish mallet. Now this is done by continuing to use my roughing gouge. Starting about a third of the way down the length of this roundish type shape, I simply start roughing in where the handle meets the head by removing the material. Soon I switch to my spindle gouge, or is it a bowl gouge? I'm pretty sure it's a spindle gouge. Please bear with me, I'm seriously new to turning and have a hard time telling the difference between some of the tools. So using the spindle gouge, I further define the base of the mallet where it meets the handle. My third lesson, it's going to happen right about when I discover there's a bit of a technique to how you roll the spindle gouge so that it doesn't catch and then tear into the wood. Maybe you heard some of that in the background there. I still have a little ways to go to fully understand the tools. Okay, a long way to go, but I'm starting to make progress, and that's the most important part. Next, it's time to return to the roughing gouge and start making further progress on the handle. You can see I'm starting to further define where the handle meets the mallet head and the base, and again, I'm relying pretty much on my roughing gouge to do most of the work for me. I'm simply going to sweep it back and forth by resting it on the tool rest and using my body to move it left and right, keeping it pretty much in the same exact plane. Stopping once in a while to get a true feel before moving on. Then to further refine the shape at the top and bottom of the handle, I grab my spindle gouge, again, I'm pretty sure it's the spindle gouge, and I start rolling those edges. At one point, I start to realize I probably was removing more than I needed, and as a result, I ended up messing up my shape and had to slightly redefine it. Now, with the handle pretty much completed, I then move on to the head of the mallet and do a little slight round over at the very top. Again, using what I do believe is the spindle gouge. The last part to work on is the base itself. Now, I thought about leaving it a little wider diameter, but then I realized I actually wanted it just a little bit smaller. So first, I'm going to use the roughing gouge. And then eventually, it's back to the spindle gouge to soften the edges and round it over ever so slightly. Now, with all the shaping done, I remove it from the lathe, and I get a good feel for it in my hand. It's actually not bad. It's a little light, but I think there's enough heft here to help me with some light chisel work, so that's perfectly fine. Now it's back onto the lathe for some sanding, including a little burnishing with some of the chips. Then I apply a friction finish called shallow wax. Now it's called a friction finish because once you apply it, you then immediately come back in with a rag and you apply some friction to the surface, and that causes the finish to dry rather quickly, and it really gives it a beautiful, nice luster. So the result is a nice little mallet for the shop and a great learning opportunity for more projects coming up later. If you have comments, questions, or suggestions, I'd love to hear from all of you. You can email me at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com, or you can stop by the website at mattsbasementworkshop.com, where you can leave a comment in today's show notes. If you're watching this over at YouTube, you can leave a comment over there. I love hearing from all of you. So until the next time, who knows, maybe we'll be doing another wood turning project, or maybe we'll go back to some flat work. Not really sure at this point, but whatever it is, I'll be talking to you soon. Straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody. Thanks for watching. To find even more videos and woodworking-related content, be sure to visit our website at mattsbasementworkshop.com. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. And don't forget to subscribe to the show either on YouTube, in iTunes, or you can even receive email notifications whenever we post something new.